Well, we're throwing a bit of the bathwater out with this budget build, but as for this $1,600 baby, it's here to stay. And this build is all Team Red, including the latest in Radeon graphics. And we're gonna tell you all about it right here, right now on Robitech. You've asked for it, and like Echo 419, you know our motto,
we deliver.
We have an all AMD build using both current gen AMD CPU and GPU. Now, we are breaking our budget threshold by about 60%, but we wind up with a machine that is a stunner at 1440p gaming. Keep in mind that these prices are subject to change, but at the time of this video, around $1,600 was where we landed specifically with this build. Right now, the prices for components and all of those things, as well as availabilities for GPUs, are all in flux, but we've been seeing little signs of improvement. So for a video like this, we want to give you a picture of what a super lean all AMD build looks like. And when the time comes, you have this guy just waiting for you. And don't worry, we're still going to talk about part recommendations, show you where to get the best deals, and reference the live stream for step-by-step instructions on how to build this machine right here for yourself. So sticking with our budget build rules, we'll be using a 5-point weight system to show you how this budget build is balanced within the following categories: price, or how well did we use our budget, and really, since we're breaking the budget, our focus is going to be thriftiness elsewhere. CPU power, GPU power, parts and features, things like RGB, CPU cooler, RAM speeds, and SSD performance, and finally, aesthetics. And remember, this video is only part of the story. You can watch the step-by-step guide with all the close-up shots, explanations of what we're doing and why, and to help you build a PC like this one for yourself. And you can find that over at Robitech Live or just by clicking on the link right here. And also make sure you like, subscribe, and ring the notification bells here at Robitech and over at Robitech Live so you don't miss our next budget build stream. All right, this build, as we mentioned, is focused on one of AMD's current CPUs paired with one of its latest GPUs. Starting with our CPU and motherboard, we're using the AMD Ryzen 5 9600X with the ASUS TUF Gaming B850 Plus Wi-Fi motherboard. The Ryzen 5 9600X is a 6-core 12-thread CPU that gets us into the current Zen 5 platform as well as an AM5 socket. One of the things we really like about this CPU and the 9000 series as a whole is that they are crazy powerful while staying crazy efficient, which means crazy cool. As for the motherboard, we're moving up in the world. We're using the ASUS TUF Gaming B850 Plus Wi-Fi motherboard. The TUF Gaming B850 Plus Wi-Fi has a reinforced PCIe 5 lane for our GPU, as well as PCIe 5 M.2 slots and two PCIe 4 M.2 slots for storage. Even better, all of these M.2 slots have heatsink, and the motherboard also supports Wi-Fi 7. It has support for high-speed I/O and a number of ASUS EasyPC DIY features. And if you want to save a little money, but you know that you're going to lose some of those things, you can drop down to the B650 if you wanted to. So for our parts and features and CPU power scores, which we didn't skimp on anything, so we went with all the latest stuff, given we're using a current gen motherboard and CPU, this will bump up parts and feature score to the upper middle for now, while letting our CPU power at the top end of the middle. While this isn't the most powerful CPU on the market, it's hard to argue that it isn't a rock star among budget chips. As for CPU cooling, we're using the Thermalright Phantom Spirit 120SE ARGB air cooler. We do actually have to spend some money here because the 9600X doesn't come with a stock cooler. If there was a stock cooler, using the Phantom Spirit might have taken some budget points away, but since we're going well over $1,600, it's not like we have any budget points to work with in this build anyway. This cooler will, however, earn us some aesthetic points and nudge parts and features up ever so slightly. Moving on to RAM, we're using 32 gigabytes of G-Skill Triton Z5 Neo RGB. This kit is rated at 6,000 megatransfer with a cast latency of 30. Overall, great specs for Ryzen, and as a point of reference, with the Neo in the name, that lets us know that it has Expo profiles for AMD, so it's all wins all day here. We actually looked at comparable non-RGB kits at the time of putting this build together to see if we could save some money, but it was actually $2 more expensive. Could we give ourselves some points for our overall budget score? Well, I think that ship has sailed so far out of the harbor that we can't even reach it, nor can we even see it from the shore. Now moving on to our GPU, we're using the Gigabyte Gaming Radeon RX 9070 XT. This RX 9070 XT is supposed to retail for $660, which is pushing our budget closer to that $2,000 mark than we'd like, but at this point, what modern like Radeon 90 series or NVIDIA 50 series GPU wouldn't? Now you may notice that either in this build right here or over on the step-by-step guide that we're actually using a Sapphire card. The reason we recommend the Gigabyte card is it's like the last of the OG MSRP cards for the Radeon 9070 XTs that are actually left. So if you can get one at that price, that's the win right here. So as far as our scoring goes, GPU power is going to land in the upper middle range while our budget takes a little bit of a hit. Oh, our poor budget. Now moving on to our storage, we're using a 2 terabyte Kingston Renegade NVMe drive. This isn't a drive we typically find in our budget builds, but we love it for our personal rigs. It has super fast read and write speeds, and at the time of making this video, we're able to snag a 2 terabyte version for around $170. Now, if you wanna go cheaper, you could save around $30 by going with the Kingston 2 terabyte NV3, which we actually used in our 5070 build. You lose DRAM and some speed, but you keep that capacity. So for scoring in this build though, we're gonna bump up our parts and features, since this is an amazing drive and it doubles our entry point for storage, and it gives us that extra speed that we want. Now for our case, we have an old favorite, the Fantex XT Pro Ultra. We love this case for a whole laundry list of reasons. It comes with 4 pre-installed RGB fans, it's easy to build in, and it offers great airflow. As for pricing, we've seen the XT Pro Ultra on sale for as low as $70, but at the time of this build, thank you tariffs, it was closer to $96. That being said, it's still an amazing case for budget builds. So this case doesn't do much for our budget at this time, but it's both functional and it looks really, really good. So that's a bump up to aesthetics as well as parts and features. And finally for the PSU, we're back with the old reliable, the ASUS TUF Gaming 750 watt gold PSU. If you haven't heard us say this out loud, we love this power supply. First of all, it comes with a 16 pin GPU cable that is rated for 600 watts. Also, not only that, but the included cables are a treat to manage. They also look good, so you don't really need to use or buy cable extensions, which could save you $30 to $35. So when we put this all together, the total cost before taxes and shipping comes in at around $1,600. So if you're gonna score in our 5 categories, here's where things would land. CPU and GPU power both land in the upper middle range, with GPU power being slightly higher. With everything we added in this build, parts and features are maxed out. There really isn't much else you could ask for at this level. As for aesthetics, we're staying in the upper mid range, but we really love how this combination of parts looks together. And finally, for our budget score, we broke our $1,000 rule with a number of extras. So no points there. I actually think we're in debt in the budget build bank. Now that we know what our dollars are buying, let's talk about how those dollars transform into gaming performance. The numbers we're gonna show you first represent raw data without FidelityFX super resolution, fluid motion frames, or ray tracing. And since there are a lot of numbers here, we call out highlights, but if you wanna see these charts in more detail as well as 1080p performance, you should head over to robitech.com and check them out under budget builds tab. All right, so diving into raw performance, the RX 9070 XT is a real 1440p beast. In most of the tested titles, we see it pushing frame rates over 80 frames per second in all but one of our tests, while exceeding 100 frames per second in most. A few standout examples include Indiana Jones with an average of around 155 frames per second at supreme settings, 105 frames per second in Space Marine 2, and over 129 FPS in Cyberpunk 2077. It's worth noting here that we test Fortnite at low settings in order to maximize frame rates for competitive play, and the averages there landed at over 287 FPS. Now, when we add FSR, we're also adding real-time ray tracing elements, so you're gonna see some dips in a couple titles, while in others, you'll see performance on par with raw performance, or even in some cases better. Games like Space Marine 2, Forza Horizon 5, and Cyberpunk 2077 took a slight hit, but still hover over 100 FPS, while Indiana Jones, Black Myth Wukong, and Hogwarts Legacy need a bit of help carrying the ray tracing load. Fortunately, these games get some help crossing that 60 FPS threshold thanks to fluid motion frames, but the biggest story here is that games like Starfield, Marvel Rivals, Star Wars Outlaws, Cyberpunk 2077, and Space Marine 2, all of them taking astronomical leaps in performance with FSR and fluid motion frames all working together. We love to see it overall. This thing is a tiny titan for the price. Now, gaming performance data is great, but how did the case and air cooler handle temps? Well, our 9600X stated an average temperature of around 62 degrees Celsius under full CPU load, and yes, you heard that right, 62 degrees Celsius. As far as temperature on the RX 9070 XT, it averaged 50 to 55 degrees Celsius in Furmark, which is really good under such a brutal load. As for gaming temps, we averaged between 50 to 52 degrees in Cyberpunk 2077, and around 66 to 68 degrees Celsius on the 9600X. Overall, these are really good temperatures out of the box. As always, keep in mind that we didn't set a fan curve for our GPU or CPU here, so there's actually room for some potential improvement. As we wrap this up, all of our budget builds, the parts list, performance charts, and the live streams can be found over at robitech.com. And if you have other components you want to try on this build, be our guest. This is a really flexible platform with modern components and features, so it can really set up a build for success. Not only that, the cooler worked really well for our 9600X, so you could comfortably bump that up to, like I said before, a 9700X or even a 9800X 3D. Also, understand that the price of this build assumes that you can get all of these components at MSRP, or at least in the neighborhood. We are seeing some market shift in price fluctuations, but cost and availability seem to change on a dime these days. So take this build here as a guide to help you figure out what you want to build when it's time. But if you want to know more about how the 9070 XT runs with a modern CPU, now you know. And with that, we're going to close out this rundown of the Robitech Modern Team Red Budget Build PC featuring the AMD Ryzen 5 9600X and the AMD Radeon RX 9070 XT. And as always, please let us know if you built this yourself by joining the Robitech Discord. This is a great place to ask any questions you may have along the way. And if this configuration doesn't match what you're looking for, we have more on the website and even more coming soon. We'll be building these live over at twitch.tv/Robitech or at Robitech Live right here on YouTube. And we'll have breakdown videos like this one right here on the main Robitech channel. So slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here at Robitech. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.